Anurag Kashyap. I when I see him bearing the flag of women liberations, talking about women patriarchy, I understand what a fucking hypocrite he is. I went to meet him, and the next day when he took me to the other room, he just opened his zip and tried to force his cock inside my vagina by opening the nara of my salwar. And then he said, like, it's okay, all the actresses who worked with me, like Huma Qureshi, like Richa Chadda, Mahi Gill, they are just a call away. And whenever I call them, they just come running and suck my cock. That's what he told me, and he expected me to do the same. So I said, so I'm very uncomfortable, and I'm not mentally prepared for this right now. Let me go. I will definitely come back, and we'll have a good time. But right now, I'm not mentally or physically or emotionally ready for it. I'll definitely meet you at a big director. You do give all small timers good films, and you are very creative, I know, because you have given chance to Richa Chadda, Mahi Gill, Huma Qureshi, they are so nominal looking girls. Normal, generally directors won't give them chance, but you have given them, and it's a very good thing. You have done a very great job. But I'm not mentally prepared for this right now. I will definitely come back, and I'll talk to you about it, and then we'll have a good time. But I want to go back. Though it wasn't like nothing happened between us, that as long as I couldn't stop him, that time it like till then everything happened. After that, when I could, then he told me that well, it's a very normal thing in film industry, and being into relationship and being kind of in a physical relationship is not a big deal. I told him, yeah, but for that you need to have that kind of my wavelength, wavelength should match. And then when you especially work, then you start liking someone, maybe the director or the hero, you fall in love, or you start liking the person for the time being, and getting into that kind of relationship is fine. But I don't understand this kind of relationship where people talk about like just going, nobody is a prostitute. When a girl come to a director to meet him to talk about film and hoping that they might get a chance in their film, that doesn't mean they are prostitute. So you cannot even talk and even behave with those girls the way that as if they are prostitute and paying money to them and they will come and sleep with you. The next day he called me again. He said, like, I would like to discuss something with you. I went to his place. He was drinking whiskey or scotch, whatever, I don't know. And it was like smelling very bad. I could easily feel it was some charas or ganja or some kind of drugs, I don't know. As I don't have any idea about those things, but I could feel it. I'm not a stupid. Then he was talking to me. He said, why don't let's go to the other room. I went to his other room, where it was filled with cassettes, books, mostly cassettes of music cassettes and video cassettes. It was completely a library, actually, of cassettes and books. And there was a sofa, and there was a TV as well. I went there, we sat, and he said to me that that time he was shooting for Bombay Velvet with Ranbir Kapoor. He said, like, any girl is ready to sleep with me just to have a, just to share a scene with Ranbir Kapoor. And girls are so crazy about Ranbir Kapoor. I said, yeah, no wonder. He said, yeah, and they are ready to sleep. They are ready to do anything just to share a scene with Ranbir Kapoor. I said, good. And he is charming. He is really good. So But this kind of approach of girls are something very stupid, and I think that because of this kind of approach, girls are mostly been cheated, because they make their mind and body and soul very easily available. I told him, write this thing, write on his face. He told me, I come from a very humble family, and I used to be a huge fan of Amitabh Bachchan. Today, after reaching so much height, Amitabh Bachchan calls me and asks me for work, for him, for his son. And I am enjoying this legacy. It's good. I said, it's very appreciating. Like a person coming from UP and then settling in Bombay, and even the big dude like Amitabh Bachchan is calling and asking for work. It's a big deal, and it's your luck and his humbleness. He said, like, that's what I have achieved in life. Karan Johar now every day calls me and talk to me for everything he wants to talk, and that is what I have achieved. So you should understand that how big a person I am, and you should not deny, or you should not throw tantrums, or you should not even think of not getting involved with me, and that will benefit you in your near future. And then you have to do theaters also. I will recommend you and all this stuff, and so many other things also. He talked to me, but finally he ended up opening up his zip and tried to open my clothes and forcefully tried to push it into me. So but I wanted to say many times, but everybody told me that don't say. They are very, very, very scary people. They might put they may do acid attack on you, or they may kidnap you. We have heard so many things about them, and how they trouble other actors. So don't talk about it.